Hello and welcome back to episode 8 of American Outback. I am Jim Bob. This is the final episode before the DLC drops. And we are in a frantic rush. Actually, I need to be at this end of the field now. I can't just pop in between the two ends because there aren't two ends anymore. It's all linked together. We did that in the last episode. So, he's parked there. We need to quickly get the auger, which I think it needs emptying. Oh, it's a mad scramble, a mad dash to get everything done at the same time. Let's quickly get this auger emptying. Right, while he's doing that, let's get this guy. Oh, the combine's full. Let's get that filling up. So, combine. Let's end the job. We may as well park this right next to the auger, empty into the auger, into the tipper. Look at the money going down. It's just flooding out of the account at the moment. That's the seed and the fertilizer costs. There we go. So he's doing that. This is now ready. Let's drive this over to our new monster length field. I really do like this setup, the Optum with the twin wheels, and then the pull behind sprayer and the tank. You'll recognise that as the cover image on my channel. That was actually taken when I was playtesting the farm before the update went live. And I was spraying a field of wheat or barley, I'm not entirely sure which. And then I did also do some spraying of a different field with soybeans on it as well, but I think I ended up going for the... Actually, which one did I go for? Let me have a look at my channel banner. We need to be in here, don't we? Let's unfold the sprayer. There we go. It was a soybean field that I was actually using as my banner image. So that was taken on a different version of this map. It wasn't this playlist. But I do love that setup. You know, the twin care wheeled Optum with the spraying front and rear tanks. It just looks awesome like that. Okay, so capacity 44,000. We've got 26,000 left available before that's full. That should be covered by the field. By what's left on the field easily. And now we need to decide what we're going to sell. And I'm going to go with soybeans again. Like I said, it's all about raising money on this field. We'll do something different on fields 20 and fields 2, but this field here is going to be soybeans again. Put us a nice little banker crop in to get him started. Where is the auger? There it is. Trying to think if there's any other jobs that we can do at the same time as getting all of this done. I don't think there is. I think that might be the last pass on this field as well. Is he leaving any? Oh, he's got one more after this. Alright, so in that case, How's he looking? Oh, he's pretty much empty, so yeah. We don't even need the auger up here. We'll take this back to the farm. And we're going to be a little bit naughty. We're going to cut across the train tracks. So I'm just trying to get everything done as quickly as possible. So we'll go and put this guy in position. We'll have a different tractor running the auger. We'll be using... Actually, no, we'll carry on using this one, and we'll use the... we'll use our spraying tractor to actually run the baler to pick up the straw bales. Because we also need to pick up some loose straw. In fact, actually, we might... Yeah, we'll get some bales, just for the ease of making food, because of the mixed rations. Making sure we've got the percentage right. We'll do this little bit ourselves. Not least because we'll be able to make this turn quicker and get started faster. There we go. But also just saves us an extra few dollars as well. It is kind of a mad scramble to make sure that we are operating as absolutely efficiently as we possibly can. Like I said, this is the last episode before the Big Bud DLC drops. 2 days to go. Technically less than 2 days. Depends on where you are in the world. If you're in Australia, 1 day to go. Australia, New Zealand, they are, 13 or so hours ahead of me here in the UK. So they will get it midway through Monday. I will get it at midnight, or just after, fractionally after midnight, here in the UK on Tuesday the 9th. And then America will start to get it 5 hours later, or six or eight, depending on where you are. Canada as well, 7 hours behind, depending on whereabouts on that time band you are. But yeah, 1.5 days until this goes, until I get my hands on that DLC. Because it's probably around about 6-7 o'clock on Sunday evening, as this video goes live, UK time. Which means just got to go to midnight, then it's Monday, and then midnight again, and it's DLC. So yeah, I'm really getting excited now. Really getting excited. It is already bought and paid for, because I bought the season pass before the Coon DLC came out. So I've picked up all the the snake tractors, for Challenger. I have the full set of field snakes. There we go, drop the harvester there. No, fold, there we go. It's time to go and get started as quickly as we can on Field 2. So yeah, I've got the field snakes, I've got the Fent Black Beauty, I've got the Black Massey with the jewels. I've got the freebie that was given out to everyone who has a PS Plus account on PSN, New Holland Blue Power T7. Trying to think if there is another DLC tractor. I think there was the Cow Edition that came as a pre-order bonus as well. The Cow Edition voucher, which I never use. I think it looks ugly. I'll tell you what, to be honest, I don't tend to use the Field Snakes that much. I don't tend to use Challenger that much, really. I tend to use the tracked challenges from time to time, but very rarely do I use the largest of the challenges. We may well incorporate Challenger into this map as well. So add another big American brand into this one. So we'll have Case, Challenger, and Big Bud. I just don't know if there'll be space for all those different full-size tractors on this farm, though. You know, we'll have, you know, the Big Bud, we'll have the 450 and the 747. You know, in terms of Case, then we still don't have a Magnum, which is the next size up. And then beyond that, we've got the Quad Track. You know, and then you've got three very powerful Challengers to add into that mix as well. It's going to be tough fitting them all in. I think the Challenger will probably end up run, you know, be working silage plant maybe. You know, we are going to run some silage on this farm. Let's see if we get hit with the bump. Maybe, maybe not. I went to look out the back window and of course there is no back window. Oh, he stopped, he saw us. That's one advantage of the slow moving traffic, is that they stop pretty quickly. If this was Cobra Park, we would have been absolutely rammed at full speed there, which wouldn't have been good. So let's drop the header. There we go. Spin around. Now, because we've been harvesting soy, it's not going to give... Oh, no, it has given me the option to enable. There we go. Normally it doesn't. Which is kind of frustrating. You know, you have to actually, you know, start putting crop through. And then you can switch it on or off. Because it just default switches it off if you have it, you know, a different crop active. And there we go. We'll start making some straw. I'm actually going to... reposition slightly because I think we might be missing a strip here on the edge. Nope, we weren't. My imagination. But at least we know. So, there we go. He's repositioned. I need to empty this. So, oh wow, we've got a lot more than I thought. So we had 75. Well, no, we made 70, didn't we? I said we would end up with 100 to 110. We've actually ended up with 120 from those three fields that we've harvested. 120,000 in soybeans. And we've got another 5, 6, 7,000 already in the silo as well. So that's quite a nice little amount there. You know, 135,000, 136,000. That'll definitely raise a pretty penny. And then obviously we've got however much wheat we're going to get off this field as well. And the bales. The baling's going to have to be done off camera. I'm just not going to have time to get all of that done. Like I said, I'll be keeping some bales. I'll be selling the rest. Just to raise that a little bit of extra money. But we'll be selling the grain at the start of episode 9. Our crops may or may not be ready by then. We'll see. And what I will do as well is, seeing as we've started planting one field and we'll have to speed time up to get the crops, you know, sold at the best price, I will go ahead and replant the other two fields. And get them fully planted as well. So when we come back, you know, the fields won't be fully harvested. Won't be fully ready to harvest. They will be planted at stage 2 fertilization. And then we'll be speeding time up to sell stuff. And that will determine what we actually get. So let's park the truck just there. How is the harvester doing for capacity? Looks like 65% or so. So you can do three runs. Useful to know. However, we will be catching him on this downhill run anyway, because once he gets down to the bottom and fills up, we won't be able to empty him. So I'll let him turn. Look at that lovely straw. We'll go and drop some of that for our cows in just a second. Give them some bedding. I have absolutely no idea. Oh, doing it again. Stopping him from moving. Need to keep him moving. It cuts down on how much I have to pay him. And it just makes this a much more fluid job, a faster job. But, yeah, I have no idea how much straw is going to be needed to give my cows enough to max out their bedding. I probably won't max out their bedding. I'll probably just do a couple of lines of straw, and hopefully that'll be enough. And if it's not, well, unless the requirement is way down, yeah, that should be fine. And we can sell what, if we do have enough, we can sell whatever gets left over, and then the rest of the field past these first two lines will probably get baled up, so that we have some straw bales for making TMR. And then yeah, if we, once we've got enough bales, if we have enough left over, we'll sell some of those as well, just to really, really raise as much money as we possibly can. So let's park that there for a second. Where is my sprayer? He should be done. Not quite. He's still got a whole pass to do. And this is the problem with these fields, is that they're just not wide enough for this particular spraying kit. So, like I said, he's finished his job. He hasn't. He's still got all this to do, but he won't hire because it's not wide enough. Maybe if I drive down a little bit further. Oops. I might as well just run with him, to be fair. Save the wages, because I need to fold him and move him as soon as he's done anyway. It's just a shame it's so slow. 7 miles an hour. So yeah, we'll look to see if we can extend the width of this field ever so slightly. Go a couple of rows out to the left, a couple of rows out to the right. It won't be a huge amount, but you know, it all adds up. We are about 20 minutes or so into the episode now, so we are what, halfway through field two? That'll be done. That'll definitely be done, and hopefully we'll have bedding down for the cows. Oh, my tablet is bonging because the battery's dying. Everything I own needs replacing at the moment. Yeah, my PS4 is sounding like it, you know, it needs something replacing. Hopefully it's just the hard drive and not the PS4 itself. My tablet needs replacing because it's old and knackered, falling apart. My phone needs replacing because it's old and knackered and falling apart. My microwave has just been replaced because the old one was old and knackered and fell apart. Just kind of clinging on, you know. This is sometimes the problem with technology. You buy everything in groups and then it all starts to fail at around the same time. Or sometimes you just get really unlucky and everything just happens to fail at the same time. Which is what's happening with me. My, as I say, my tablet is, ooh, it's actually quite old now. It's a Asus TF300T, Android tablet. It's only running 4.1, so it's old. You know, still running Jelly Bean. And I think I've had it for 5 years now, maybe? 5.5 years? I'm trying to think. No, maybe not that long. Maybe 4.5 years. Let's see, I've been in this particular location now for over 3. You know what? Yeah, it is about 5 years old. And it wasn't a brand new, well, it was brand new to me when I bought it, but it wasn't like the brand new model off, you know, when I bought it. You know, it wasn't the most up-to-date model. So it had, you know, that particular model had already been out for about a year, I think, when I bought it. So it's lasted pretty well. I mean, it still works, it still functions and everything, but it's getting to the point where it's just not working as well as it should. And he's not on a worker, is he? And he won't. Yeah, I'm gonna have to finish this guy off. We're almost at the end of the field. Keep an eye on the combine. Go and empty him as soon as we. As soon as he gets to the end of the field, I'll be turning around and going back for him. He's going to get there before I do, I think. Yeah, he's going to... I don't know, I've got a mile an hour on. Oh, no, he's full. Okay, so let's turn that off. That's a shame. Is my tablet bonging on me again? So let's park. Ooh. Like that. And skip to the harvester. And turn and empty. And then he'll should be able to finish the rest of the field on a single tank. Let's put the map away now. Come on, I'm getting impatient. Hurry up, there we go, it's empty. Let's get this guy back to work. Let's finish off this little bit of field here. Oh, we've still got so much to do, just no time left to do it. I was really hoping we would have been able to make more money than this. I mean, like I said, I could do some off-camera contract work, but I really don't want to have to do that. I mean, maybe it was a mistake to buy that field. But it gave us, you know, a huge volume of soybeans. Probably not enough to actually cover the cost of buying the field. We probably shouldn't have bothered buying that field. But it was just such an inviting opportunity, I kind of couldn't say no to it. You know, a field that was fully ploughed, fully fertilised, had soybeans on it, was ready to go, and was already discounted a bit as well. You know, I could probably have just worked it and banked the money and be done with it, but... Ah, well. We are where we are. Right. Let's empty this, and then we can drop off the auger. And grab the loading wagon. Start picking up some straw for our cows. Finally give them something to sleep on. Stop getting dirty looks from the cows every time I drive past the field. We need to really sort out their feed area as well, but I've got nothing to scoop up there. This is the problem, I've got nothing to scoop up the stuff on the floor with now. Not that I did anyway, really. Seeing as that bucket didn't work, and I tried off camera and it didn't work. So I've got nothing to scoop up the mess, and it is starting to get pretty messy, so it's going to affect the productivity of our cows quite a bit. You know, if it starts getting too much more out of hand. Where does the auger wagon live? I can never. Oh, it lives next to the fieldwork equipment, so it lives over here. This slot just here. There we go. So we drop the auger there. Let's go get our loading wagon. I have a huge mess. I don't actually know where to tip the straw in either. Because they need it. Yeah, but where do I put it? There's no obvious place. I'm going to see if it will take it at the straw at the feed trough. Maybe that's where it gets tipped, but I'm curious as to where it's going to appear on the field. Really curious. Okay, so he is done. So let's lower, turn on. Just grab some of this straw. See how much we get, and that'll give me a rough idea as to how many bales we can expect out of each pass. That's two. That's three bales. Can we go for four bales per pass? Yes, we can. That's four bales. Nearly 4.5 bales per pass. That's not bad. That's not bad at all. We've got, so I'm going to do these two for straw bedding. So we're going to have 5.5, because the other one is a narrow width. Effectively, 5.5 sets. So that's what? 4.5 bales times 5 is 9, 18, 22.5, and another half on top of that as well. So. Talking 25 bales. That's not bad. That's not bad at all. So, where do we need to tip the straw for these cows? Because I genuinely have no idea. I'm going to think that it's, well, there is a tip point there for the pigs. I wonder if there's one around the other side of the field for the cows. Let me cruise on round and see. So that's the dialogue box. You can see the mess there by the food trough. Is there a tip point along this side of the field? Because I know this is where the grass and water troughs go. It doesn't look like there is. No. Well, let's see. Can we unload here? Yes, we can. Not accepted here. What about here? Not accepted there. So it's got to be somewhere along here. It's obviously going to go here by the food trough. That area there looks like it's going to be where the straw goes. You see little patches of it there. So let's try... Yeah, there we go. Oh, wow, look at that. That's enough. Okay, so we can sell the rest of this straw, and I've realised I can use... I put hay in there, didn't I? I did, but not much. Look at the cleanliness, it's only 7%. But they have straw now, which is good. I can use the forage wagon to actually pick up that loose food over there. So let's drive this in here. Let's dump this. We made $1,000. That's not bad. To be honest, I didn't even expect to make that much. So I'll take that $1,000. Let's go pick up that discarded grass. Clean the feed area up, and this way we can boost the productivity of our cows. Maybe actually make some decent money at the end of the night. That was a mistake. Trying to turn where I couldn't. Alright, so let's finish this cleanup operation. This is just something we're going to have to do on a daily basis. You know, I could get a Lely. I think I might actually get a Lely Juno at some point in the future, but I mean, I don't have 12 grand to spare on one of those just yet. Okay, there we go. Now, I don't think this is going to let me tip here. Oh, no, it will. It's gone in. So we put that back in the food trough. Oh, no. I meant to turn the... Why is nothing working? I'm pressing the wrong shoulder button. I'm pressing R1 instead of L1. That's why I'm turning the engine off and turning the lights on instead of turning the wagon off and raising the pickup. So we can go put our wagon away again. We don't need this just yet. In fact, we may... Well, do we really need to keep one of these? It would make things a lot simpler going forward when it comes to filling up a hay barn. But as things stand right now, yeah, we can get away with baling, so may possibly sell that in the next episode if we need the extra cash. We'll see. But we may sell the loading wagon. We can always rent one if we need one in the future, I suppose. Alright, so there's the last of the wheat. Wonder how much we actually made in total on that field. Because it's not a big field. Not really. So I am curious as to how much we will have actually made. And I think we've got a pretty good price on wheat at the moment, so we might sell our wheat right now here at the end of the episode. cut through the fence, through the ridge line there. Is our what's going to be our truck depot. Turn in here. Let's get the header lined up. There we go. Release the header. Park the combine right next to it. There we go. Is that all? Only 33 and a half. I thought we would have made more than that. I was expecting somewhere between 40 and 50,000 litres. Well, we should have around 6, 7, 8,000 litres in our silo already. So, let's pull into the farm. And let's check pricing. So what can we get? 724 at the old grain store. Yes, we're going to go and sell this right now. At the very least, it'll clear or work. It will definitely clear our negative equity in our bank balance, which means... Well, it doesn't actually mean a lot. It's not going to... It means we might be able to, you know, at least chip away at some of our loan debt. Oh, no, I'm looking at barley. All right, this goes in the silo then. We'll sell this when the price is a bit better. I mean, none of the prices are green, so we don't want to screw ourselves out of potential profits. So, we'll put this back in the silo. We'll save it. It'll get sold in the next episode. There we go. Fantastic. So, grain is stored and away. It's time to pull away our trailer. Try and get it nice and straight if we can. That's not bad. There we go, that's pretty good. Just park that, there we go, drop it off. Park the truck in front of the dolly. And we are done with the harvest. It's finished. How long do we have left? About 6 minutes. Ooh. Well, this field is done. That's good. Can't fertilise the other field yet because we haven't run the baler over it. So we'll get the baler. And I'll start baling up the what's left of the straw. And as I said, we'll be storing some of that for feed, so we can store 12 bales or so, maybe 14 bales, 16 bales. The rest we can then sell. I think we'll go for 16. That'll mean we'll have a little bit of straw left over for future bedding, as well as, you know, for feed as well. That is the problem with not having a lot of straw, is that you kind of need it for both the feed and the bedding. And when you've got a lot of cows, that can very quickly use up everything. But I would like to be able to sell some of that straw as well. So I need to kind of balance between, you know, selling and storing. Making sure I have enough for when I need it in the future. I mean, we can always, if necessary, do another wheat harvest or a barley harvest. It is a kind of a shame that we don't have barley instead of wheat, because with that price at the moment, that is a cracking little price. It's so good, in fact, that we are actually going to go and sell our barley. I don't have the right size tipper. We need a small tipper just for small grain movements. No, we'll do that. We'll do all of our grain in one go at the next episode. So let's get the baling gear. And we've got half a bale already in here. That'll immediately get converted over to hay, sorry, to straw, the second we start we start picking up. Everything unfolded and away, there we go. Good stuff. So here we go. Straw baling, we will go. So this is feed that we are baling here right now. So they are fully bedded for the next 6 days. So I'm thinking 4 passes may be enough. Not counting that first one we did, because that was only a half-width pass. Which means that 5th pass we can probably just sell. That'll get us... Oh, need to drop those off. And because this is so close, I'm not going to be messing around with the bale trailer. You know, I'll just be picking these stacks up and carrying them one at a time. With the claws back to, you know, each stack of 4 will get carried back to the shed where I'm storing my bales. Almost full already again. There we go. Drop off, close the back. Yeah, we're halfway there on our requirements for straw bales already. We need 16 bales by my reckoning. And then the rest we can just sell. I may even just bale the whole field and then save messing about with bringing the wagon back again, because I can always just, you know, drive, you know, a stack of bales straight into the shed as well. Yeah, the barn. Save messing about with equipment. Obviously, if we were at a different field, then I would be just grabbing the trailer and loading that. But because the farm is literally just there, there's no point messing about getting the trailer all hooked up, brought over, loaded, driven 50 feet, and then unloaded again. You know, it's easier to just carry the bale stacks over one by one. So there we go. That's what we need That's the four stacks. So everything else is now just a bonus. Everything else now is purely sellable. And I think this is going to be the end of the episode as well. I did say we would run slightly long on this episode. There is the buzzer. So we'll run for another 5, maybe 10 minutes. Just so we can try and get as much prep work done as possible. I don't want to do too much off camera. All I'm going to do is stack these bales. Oh, that's a point. Oh, it's too late now. I'm already pushing it out of the way. Of that. Right, let's pick up these little chunks that I left behind. So I've got two. In the stacker, I've got one on the trailer. There's like one on the baler. Plus I've got one on the ground, so I've got another full stack plus whatever change. If I can actually, I don't think I can get enough. No, I can't. So let's turn off the baler. No. Damn it, didn't need to do that. Well, you can't add additional bales once you start unloading. Even if you abort the unloading, you just pull them back in, but it won't accept anymore. So let's turn off the baler. Let's eject the bale. There we go. So let's... I'll disconnect that. Let's disconnect that. Let's fold the baler. There we go. Pickup is up. Let's drop that off. In theory, I could just do this as well, actually. I might not even need to bother messing around with the... I'm curious about that. We'll do it with this first one, but I might not even need to mess around with getting the claws, although the claws would probably be quicker. There we go. Let me just drive this straight over to... Actually, no, I need the claws because I need to actually stack these bales, not sell them all. So these ones I can sell now. Will they sell automatically, or will I have to actually empty and unload this thing to sell them? This is an interesting test. They're still there, still there, still there. Unload. Now they're gone. So there we go. They have to be fully unloaded. They're still technically inside the baler. Eggs from the chickens as well. Just desperately clutching at anything that's going to make me some money here. Alright, so that's it for this episode. So next time you see us, we will have Big Bud installed and ready to use. So next episode is going to be selling, raising as much money as we can, and we will be buying something from the DLC for this farm. I don't know what, not yet. I kind of hope it will be the Big Bud 450. I mean, I would love a 747, but we just can't afford it, and nor do we really need it at this stage on the farm. We will get one in the future, but just not straight away. But hopefully, yeah, we'll be able to add the 450. That will be my ploughing tractor. It'll free up an extra tractor for me. And that would be awesome if we can get a 450 in. Like I said, they are 225 grand. We are 15,000 in debt at the moment. That figure will go up a little bit because I have got a little bit more work to finish off here. I've got to make sure that the fields are all growing in sequence. So I have two more fields to plant, one more field to fertilize. We still haven't even finished this one yet, look. He's still got another two passes after the one he's on right now. So this is how long it's going to take to with a 9 meter. This is a 9 meter seeder. Can you imagine how long it would take? It would take 6-7 episodes if it was a 3 meter, because you'd have to be constantly refilling. If this was only a 3 meter seeder, I would go crazy. I really would. But yeah, this field needs to be finished. We need to replant field 20. We need to replant field 2. They will be done off camera. And then I'm going to close the game down. Then I'm going to speed time up a little bit and see if our soybeans drop to a very, very, very good price. And as soon as we get a good price, I will stop time. In between, I will be fertilizing the fields again or with a weeder if they are ready to be fertilized, and then that'll be it. The game will be paused, saved, ready and waiting, and then when you come back we'll be looking to buy a Big Bud 450. So with that in mind, don't forget, other farms are out there. I have Massey Manor, I have Fent Farm, both of those are coming on very nicely. I have Sandy Bay for the short farming experience, the little 30-minute episodes. You can also check out No Man's Sky. You can also check out Prison Architect. In the month of May, we will also be bringing Tomb Raider to the channel. We'll be bringing Limbo, and we'll be bringing some other little bits and bobs as well. So keep your eyes peeled to the channel for more great content coming your way soon. And keep up to date with exactly what's being planned on in terms of when stuff is going to be released, by checking out my Facebook page, www.facebook.com/JimBobPlaysGames. And as always, I will catch you back on the farm very soon.